B-Monster Laboratory here. Today we're going to create a motorized door locking mechanism using Arduino RFiD and a servo motor. You're going to want to check this one out. Well, for this video, I was looking at the lesson 21 in the Elegoo Mega tutorial, and that one is the RC522 RFID module, and I wanted to add some stuff to it to make it a practical video. So today we're going to do a simple keyless door lock. I am all about low-cost electronics projects, so today I'm going to use this wood that I got from Walmart. I got it in a craft aisle. It was a pack of four or five of them. And a little while back, I purchased a box of 10 of these servo motors off Amazon, real cheap. So I'm going to be using one of those. I'm also going to use a simple sliding lock that I had. And I'm also going to use the RFID module that came in the Elegoo Mega kit. So in this video, I'm going to show you exactly what I did to put all this together. We're going to talk very brief about the RFID module and the servo motor because they're both new to this channel. So we're going to take a quick look at the connections. I'll show you exactly how I connected it to the Elegoo Mega board. And we're also going to take a look at the code and see how absolutely easy this is to set up. You're going to love it. Here we have the RFID RC522 module right here, the RFID module. And so this usually comes with a standard blank card right here, which I have labeled wrong ID card for what I'm doing. And then it comes with another keychain card right here. And I've labeled that correct ID for what we're doing here. Now your RFID module may or may not come with headers attached. If not, it's not a big deal. You can just solder those in yourself. What is RFID? Well, it's an acronym for radio frequency identification. It's where tags and labels are captured by a reader, which is right here, and transferred by radio waves. It's an automatic identification and data capture technology. It's also known as AIDC. It identifies an object, it collects the data on that object, and inputs data into a computer file, so to speak. And it consists of three components usually, an RFID tag or label, an RFID reader, and an antenna. There's usually an antenna in your reader here that's activated by electromagnetic field. When the ID tag is in proximity to a reader, it generates an electromagnetic field that activates the tag's antenna and powers the chip. So RFID is wildly useful. It's useful in inventory management, ID badges, restricted area access, personnel tracking, counterfeit prevention. And we'll be using the RFID RC522 module. And this particular module, as you can see, has 8 pins. And so the first pin here is your VCC pin, and it is to be connected to a 3.3 volt. That is important. If you connect it to a 5 volt, you may find yourself buying a new module. Right here next to your VCC, you see an RST pin. That is your reset pin. And when this pin goes low, it'll power down all the internal workings, the oscillator, the current sinks, and the input pins. Right next to that, you see the ground pin. That's obviously connected to ground. And then next to that, you see the IRQ pin. The IRQ pin is an interrupt pin, and that is a handy one to have, as it will alert the microcontroller when the RFID tag comes within the vicinity rather than continually sending out a signal asking if there's a tag in the area or in the vicinity. Next, we have the MISO pin, and that acts as a serial clock when the I2C interface is enabled, or it'll act as a serial data output when the UART interface is enabled. Now, the third one from the left here is the MOSI pin. That is the SPI input, the serial peripheral interface input to the RC522 module. Second to the last pin here is the SCK pin, and that accepts the clock pulses and provides that information to Arduino. And your last pin here on the left is the SDA pin, and that pin acts as a signal input when the serial peripheral interface is enabled. The servo motor is a closed loop system that relies on feedback signal to change speed and direction, and it provides rotation with precision and efficiency. Now, the servo has three wires, which you can see. The brown one is the ground wire, and that'll go into the ground port on your Elegoo board. The red wire in the middle is your VCC, and that should be connected to your 5-volt port. And the orange one, or actually it looks kind of yellowish here, that is your signal wire, and that one will go into your digital port, whatever digital port you're using. This motor contains drive gears, a motor, a shaft, a potentiometer, and a microcontroller or specialized servo IC, and an encoder, which serves as a sensor providing speed and position feedback. And with this motor, you can get the speed and position you're looking for by controlling the length of the pulse and the voltage that's applied to the amplifier. And you can see the arm up here on top. You can put a screw right there to hold it in place. It does have multiple connection points. Now, there are AC servos and DC servo motors, and they all have a range of 0 to 180 degrees. And in just a moment, we'll see how to program a servo motor and work it into what I'm going to call our smart door lock circuit. That's what I'm going to call it. So here's my connection. I have my Elegoo Mega 2560 board right here. I've got my servo motor here, and I've got my RFID, the RC522 reader right here. I've got my two LEDs right here. I'm going to show you exactly how to set this up. All right, my wiring for my RFID module here, we'll start from left to right here. You got the SDA pin. That's my black wire here on the end, and that one's connected to digital pin 53 on my board. Next, we've got the SDA pin. That's my green wire right here, and that one's connected to digital pin 52 on my board. Next up, we have the MOSI pin. That's pin number 3 here, going left to right. And that one for me is blue. If you can see the blue wire there. And that pin is connected to digital pin 51. Next pin up here on my module is the MISO pin. And for me, it's another black wire right here. And that one is connected to digital pin 50 on my board. Next up is the IRQ pin. There is no connection here. I left that one empty, as you can see. After that, we've got the ground pin. That's my orange pin. And I just connected it to the ground wire over here by digital pin 53. After that, we've got the RST pin, and that one's connected to digital pin 5, and it's my purple wire, and it keeps coming out. So we'll put that back. Finally, our VCC pin, or 3.3 volt pin, that's the red wire here. I connected that to the 3.3 pin here on my board. Be sure not to connect it to the 5 volt. All the connections that I'm using for the RFID module are the same that you see in lesson 21 in the Elegoo Mega tutorial. And here's a look at that schematic just in case you're interested. All right, now I'll show you the wiring for the servo motor. So the servo motor only has 3 wires, which is nice. So the brown wire here corresponds with this white wire, and I connected it to the ground pin on my board. The middle pin, the red pin, is your 5 volt VCC, and I just connected that over here at an open spot on my board, the 5 volt power supply. And then the orange or yellowish looking wire here corresponds with this white wire, and I connected it to my digital pin 3. The first thing I did was go ahead and connect this ground rail on my breadboard to a ground pin, an available ground pin on my board, my Elegoo board, and that is the black wire here. I then connected a ground pin to both the red and green LED from that ground rail up here. I then connected my LEDs to digital pin 8 and 9 because I want them to operate in circuit with the RFID and a servo motor. So what I did was the digital pin 9 here is the red wire, and I connected that to my green LED, and between that connection I put a 220 ohm resistor. Over here you've got digital pin 8, which is a green wire, and between that and the positive leg of my red LED I have another 220 ohm resistor. So that's my setup. Fairly easy, fairly simple, and straightforward. Now it's time to take a look at the code. Now the first thing you want to do is open up your Arduino IDE and come to this file called dump info. Go to file and then you go to examples, go down here to MFRC 522, you go up to dump info and you would load that onto your board. Then you'll want to go up here to Tools and bring down the serial monitor. Click on that, and you should get this right here pop up. If you don't get this, go back out, go down here, and make sure that you have the reset pin and the SS pin correct. For me, my reset pin is in pin 5, and the SS pin is located at pin 53 on my Elegoo Mega board. So make sure that's correct. Then you want to go back up here, go to Tools, go to Serial Monitor, and this should pop up. At this point, we're going to scan our card. So you're going to pick up your key tag, you're going to hold it in front of your scanner, and keep it there as it loads on your serial monitor. So this is the memory data that is on your key tag. It totals out to be about 1K memory overall, and it is split into 16 sectors. It goes from sector 0 all the way to sector 15. Those sectors are divided into blocks, 4 blocks each, and each block is divided into 16 bytes. Block 3 of each sector is called the sector trailer, and that contains access bits to grant read and write access to the remaining blocks in the sector. So that actually means that we're just using blocks 0, 1, and 2 in each sector for data storage. And it's also important to know that block 0 of sector 0 is the manufacturer block with manufacturer data. It contains the IC manufacturer data, the unique ID, unique identifier, and it's the manufacturer block. If you mess with it, if you change it, you may disable your card, so don't even bother that one. What we do need to know for our code is the UID, and that is the first 4 sets of numbers and letters right here in the manufacturer block. It's also listed up here, the card UID. This is what you need to know for the code. You can either write it down or hold control, press C, and copy and paste it into the code. You can also scan your other card and look at that UID as well if you want to use both cards. And we see that UID right down here in the manufacturer block. And if we scroll to the top for the second card there that I scanned, the white one, we see that that manufacturer or the UID is right here as well. You can use both UIDs for both cards in the code to grant access with the RFID scan if that's what you want to do. I'm just using one. Here is the code that I used for the RFID with lock and with a red and green light. It's basically lesson 21 code for the RFID module, and I included some extra code that involved the servo and the red and green LED. So first of all, don't forget to include your libraries. It's important that you include the correct pins for your SS pin and your RST pin. My SS pin is at 53 and my RST pin is at pin 5 on my microcontroller. Come down here and include the servo information. It's going to start at angle 0. And then we come down here and the tag UID is the ID that we got from the serial monitor earlier. And if you want another one, if you want more than one card, you can add it right next to this. I believe you just need a comma there, and then you can add the other UID as well. So that is important, otherwise your card won't work. Down here I set the red and green LED as an integer at pin 8 and 9. Down here in the setup I said that my servo is attached to pin 3 on my Elegoo board, and this initiates my RFID module. This right here sets up the red and green pin as an output and has parameters for going high and low. If you come down here to the loop, this is looking for the card. It's looking for the card ID that you included up here. You may have one, you may have more. In the loop, it begins looking for the card. It will select one of the cards or card, and if the card that you scan matches the ID that is in our code, you have access. And if that is true, the green LED pin will go high, it will turn on, then it will delay, and it will turn off. That's here too. I'm not sure that I need that there, but I'm just going to leave it because it's working. Also, if this is true and it detects the card with the ID that we've included in the code above, the servo motor will activate and move 180 degrees. It will delay for 5 seconds and then move back to zero. If you scan a card and the UID does not match what we've put in the code, then access is denied and the red LED will go high. It will light up, indicating that that it's the wrong card. And that's our loop. That's pretty much it. If you want this code, just let me know. I can post it online. Otherwise, you can just copy what you see here. If you're looking for simple STEM projects or beginner hobby electronics, this is probably a really good place to start. It could also be a nice science fair coding project where you're creating a motorized lock using a servo motor and an Arduino RFiD. That's also an idea. You could also easily turn it into a step-by-step electronics project for somebody just starting out. So it's a lot of fun. You could also easily add a buzzer and an LCD screen to this project. If you're interested in that, let me know. Well, that's all I've got for today, and as always, thank you very much for watching. I had an absolute blast with this project. You know, I said that last time, but I hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you again very soon with another one.